Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Status Report Highlight for the 11th of September 2018. To get straight into it, experimental servers are getting the stress test content update, and community server owners are now able to opt in to this latest experimental build. And yes, that does mean our very own DayZ experimental build server is ongoing the update as we speak. There is no ETA as of yet, but the details will be to follow in our Discord, which you will find in the description below. And now we shall move on to the part where I read letters to your face. Starting off with lead producer, Eugen. Dear survivors, we have some good news to share. The content update has hit the experimental branch today, and that means we're also making it available to community server owners currently hosting with one of our game server providers. Please expect slight delays as the server providers will cope with the number of switch requests. But Eugen is happy to see things finally move along to the experimental phase after most of the critical issues were fixed in our stress tests. We have implemented a large number of optimizations in our network code, which is a plus, while trying to identify an issue that in the end was caused by specific server hardware problems. And now Eugen has something that many of you probably didn't expect. But we want to see things move along at a faster pace there, so we can get feedback. We've decided to release the DayZ 0.63 server files before beta, and currently, we'd like to make them available to all DayZ players within the next week. Wait, what? Did I read that right? Everyone will be able to download the server files for free on Steam under the Tools section, and from that moment, everyone will be able to host a DayZ server on their own. Eugen thinks that with the release of server files, we will see a much broader variety of server setups and community-made game modes. And while the full modding toolset won't be available before beta, he thinks you guys have already figured a lot of the stuff out. Last but not least, our goal with the next content update that we might already call an experimental beta patch, since we will be stabilizing the internal version of the game on the stress test machines, is to have a release in as soon as the next couple of weeks. This update, again, will introduce a variety of new things, with vehicles getting in a bit later after the initial release of this next content update. We will announce the new features and content as soon as we release the first stress test build. Just to pick one example, the new restraining system that we will talk about with Adam is definitely one of Eugen's favorites. That's an amazing start to the status report so far from Eugen, but now let's move on to technical animator Adam. The current implementation of looking through a detached optic in the latest public build had a lot of problems with it. The accuracy of mouse to screen is subpar at best, and you can't accurately follow a target without moving your mouse a couple of meters. We discussed various ways to implement a solution, but Adam was mainly worried about the character not accurately displaying where someone is looking. If we were to ignore the player animation accuracy and just set the camera to be one-to-one with the mouse, other players could think that they haven't been discovered, all while the player who's looking through the binoculars could be tracking them. Adam solved this by not allowing you to move while looking through binoculars or scopes, and by doing this, Adam eliminated any external factors that could mess with the accuracy of the animation, because really, what kind of crazy person would be moving while looking through a pair of binoculars? One wrong step and you could lose your target entirely, or fall off a cliff. Here's the animation that Adam cooked up on screen now. As you can see, it's quite damn responsive, and here's how it looks while looking through it. It's in a really good state so far, and accurately displays in and out of the optics exactly where that person would be looking. Now let's talk about Eugen's favorite surrender and restrained mechanic. Surrender is a highly sought-after feature that we have been working on to deliver in the highest possible quality. At first glance, it would look like it's just another gesture, but under the hood, it holds a bunch of complexities. You can't access your inventory when you're in surrendering, not something common for gestures. You also have new stance rules where you can only walk while standing and only turn in standing and crouched. Also not something gestures can control. Lastly but not least, it also has a bunch of surrender-specific stance-changing animations, also something that gestures cannot control. With these things in mind, we had to approach the surrender mechanic with a bit more caution, as a half-assed approach would probably come back to bite us later down the line. We have solved it by essentially handling it like a gesture state on the script side, but on the animation side, it would be considered an item of sorts. The reason behind this solution is that when a player puts an item in his hands, his character will switch to the corresponding animation set. Picking up a rifle will start playing the rifle animations, pistols for pistols, and so on. With all of their specific animations for turning, changing stances, etc., by putting this ghost item into the character's hands, the surrender animation set is enabled. and the specific movement rules that the animation set has attached to it. In addition, we have opened up avenues for ourselves where we can have a bunch of surrender-specific animations, such as deaths, gestures, actions, etc, etc. Gestures in gestures. Gestureception. Why is that so hard to say? All of those same rules also apply to the restrained state. But this also means we can accurately show what item is currently restraining you, such as in this case with some locked handcuffs. Maybe down the line, you'd be able to drink face first from ponds, even while restrained, to keep yourself hydrated while running from your captors. Who knows? And that is all, boys and girls, for this week's Status Report Highlight for the 11th of September, 2018. Of course, it is a highlight, there is more information, but I kind of picked the best bits just for you. Don't forget to check out the Community Spotlight for all the great community-created content, and maybe pick yourself up a DayZ hoodie on the Bohemia Store. I've got to get me one of those. Don't forget to hit that like button, check our Discord for server details, coming very soon in the description below, and subscribe, because you know you want to, and I'll see you peeps next time.